fictional. Today on Sports World. Yes, Sports World's back and back with the best in boxing. Today's bout, a scheduled light heavyweight 10-rounder featuring Michael Spinks and Alvaro Yaqui Lopez. The 25-year-old Spinks, a 1976 Olympic gold medalist, brother of former world heavyweight champion Leon Spinks, is undefeated as a professional with a record of 13-0 with 8 KOs. Lopez, a 28-year-old Mexico-born Californian, is Spinks' toughest test to date. Yaqui has fought for the title 4 times, and ringsiders believe he should have taken 2 of those. He's 48-10-0 with 31 KOs. Spinks has got to beat him if he ever wants the crown. And then Sports World's unique... Atlantic City, New Jersey, for years a vacation resort area, offering tourists sun, sand, sailing, and the boardwalk. And with the creation of casino gambling, Atlantic City has become a blend of the old and new. One of the landmarks, the Convention Center, a massive auditorium that has housed many an athletic event, even college football, including the Liberty Bowl and the old Boardwalk Bowl. Atlantic City has gone modern. Even those hand-pushed strollers have been replaced by the motor-driven trams. And when you think of Atlantic City, you think of the Miss America pageant as seen here on NBC. And this is the land of saltwater taffy, casino gambling, and today, it's boxing from Convention Hall. Hi, everybody, I'm Marv Albert, along with the fight doctor, Ferdy Pacheco.
Well, Yaqui's been known for his bravery throughout his career and for his pressure, and that's the key to this thing, pressure versus mobility. Spinks moves a lot, and Yaqui doesn't know anything.
And Pro Bowler Steve Neff.
Oh, what a call! What a heartburn. How do you spell relief? Check the board, coach.
R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Rolaid spells relief. Unbeatable relief. Relief Tums can't beat.
Yaqui Lopez getting ready for Mike Spinks, looking to project himself back into a title shot for a fifth time. Earlier, Ferdy talked with Yaqui.
We're here with Yaqui Lopez, who is going to fight Michael Spinks, some say the next light heavyweight champion of the world. You have fought 4 times for the light heavyweight championship of the world. You have an awful lot of scar tissue. You have an awful lot of trouble with cuts. Do you think this kid, jabbing as much as he does, can open you up, can cause you trouble with the cuts?
Bueno, no, si hay una cortada, yo tengo buena gente en mi... In his esquina.
Yaqui says even if he gets cut, he's got a great corner man to take care and great cut men to take care of his cut. Tú te cansaste mucho en la última pelea. Tú puedes pelear esta vez sin cansarte.
Yo puedo pelear 10 rounds con Mike Spinks sin cansarme. Lo voy a hacer sufrir bastante.
I asked him, would he get tired since he got so tired in the last fight? He said he can go the full 10 rounds with Michael Spinks because he wants to punish him. And the final question, do you have hopes of becoming the light heavyweight champion of the world?
Yo deseo ser el número uno en México y el primer mexicano que sea un campeón mundial en mi peso.
He wants to be, yes, he wants to be the first Mexican to be the light heavyweight champion of the world. Good luck to you, Yaqui.
Thank you.
And Yaqui looking to make it back from that classic against Matthew Saad Muhammad in his last bout back in July. We'll hear from Yaqui's opponent, Michael Spinks, in a moment. This is Michael Spinks from St. Louis, Missouri, now fighting out of Philadelphia. This is his 15th professional bout. He's won his previous 14.
Leading contender for the light heavyweight crown today in one of his toughest contests with Yaqui Lopez. Michael, I see you got your skimmer on. Is there any reason for that hat?
Well, it's sort of a sweat skimmer. Wear it in the gym all the time, and I usually get prepared for every fight with it.
Brings you good luck?
Yes, I'm pretty sure it brings me a lot of luck.
Well, I hope you don't have a long career. I don't think your hat will make it through a long career, Michael. In 1976, you won the gold medal in Montreal as a middleweight. Leon Spinks, your brother, won the gold medal as a light heavyweight. And yet, all boxing people felt you would be the first champion. Leon, as everyone knows, won the heavyweight champion by defeating Muhammad Ali in Las Vegas, and then you dropped out of sight. That is to say, you worked with Leon, but you didn't fight at all, therefore damaging your career, many people feel. Why did you do that, Michael?
Well, at that time, I feel that it was confusing times for me. And I've told a lot of press people that something like that, something as big as that happening around you. I mean, you never feel something like that unless, you know, it happens in your family. And that time, it happened in my family. And I really felt it was necessary to take off because I was very confused at that time.
Well, I know you and Leon are very close as brothers. He's going to be here this afternoon. Will he work in your corner?
Well, I wish he could, but I think Leon's too emotional for the corner. And I think he'd just be good on the sideline.
But we know we will hear Neon Leon's mouth.
Oh, yes, you hear his mouth because I think Leon has the biggest mouth in the world.
All right, and good luck to you this afternoon.
Thank you very much.
Yes, it has been a strange, inactive career for Michael Spinks. After early impressive wins, he went on vacation. So today, a major test, and it's coming up.
Wets.
In the corner of Michael Spinks, his brother Leon Spinks, who was just treated by the crowd and now is being introduced by ring announcer Frank Kane. So Leon Spinks, who a moment ago was categorized by Michael as a young man with a big mouth, try to help his brother out here today.
It was a great embrace before we put him on camera that lasted a minute.
And Leon congratulates and wishes Yaki Lopez success.
Maybe not success, wishes him well
after today. And here is Yaki Lopez, 28 years old, born in Zacatecas, Mexico. Now lives in Stockton, California, 51-10. He won 31 by knockout. And Yaki has his family with him. That's his wife, Bino, and little Yaki, who is 3 years old, one of three children in the Lopez family.
The doctors in attendance at ringside, the chief physician.
And that is the father-in-law of Yaki Lopez, Jack Cruz, matchmaker and boxing promoter in California, who is now Yaki's manager and has guided him right through his boxing career. Michael Spinks, who has won 14 out of 14, 11 by knockout. He's the only 1976 U.S. Olympic gold medalist to remain undefeated as a pro. He won his Olympic title as a middleweight. That group includes brother Leon, Sugar Ray Leonard, Howard Davis, Leo Randolph. In Spinks' last fight this past August, knocked out David Conti in the eighth round. Conti ranked second in the British Commonwealth. Spinks rated fourth by the WBA, fifth by the WBC. And the introduction of Michael Spinks. Lopez ranked sixth by both the WBC and the WBA, and a win for Spinks should certainly put him in position for a mandatory defense for either the WBA or WBC title. The referee is Vinny Ranone out of Secaucus, New Jersey. Only the referee can stop the bout as we listen in.
In case of a knockdown, I'll put you in a neutral corner. Stay there, even if I reach the count of eight. I'll call you out the box. Are there any questions? Shake hands and good luck.
Referee Vinny Ranone. The judges are Eva Shane and Richard Murray. And the scoring will be round by round by the referee and the two judges. Michael Spinks in the black trunks. Yaki Lopez in the green. And we're underway. Round one, scheduled for 10 between these two light heavyweights.
Michael just threw out a very heavy jab, just sort of to say this is what's in store. He wants to establish himself early. He wants to establish the jab early so that Yaki just doesn't come on.
Mike Spinks, generally regarded as the best fighter in the Spinks family, much smoother boxer than Leon.
Much smoother, much steadier also.
He's not erratic like Leon. He is always in control.
Bertie, the question has been that early inactivity that you talked about.
It could have been disastrous to another fighter, but it came early in his career where he got over it. Yaki just put in a thundering body shot, which he's going to have to do if he gets to get Michael down off his toes.
Lopez is a slugger, likes to throw bombs. Good speed, good left jab. However, on the other hand, he is a bleeder, and that has cost him in the past.
Now, of course, is one of the primary concerns of his corner in this fight, because he's facing a man with a rapier-like jab who can open you up. Yaki's brow looks like a...
Yaki on the attack here in round one, and we're halfway through.
You can look for that in any Yaki Lopez fight. You can look for that all 3 minutes of every round, because Yaki just goes forward. As I was saying, his brow is all cut up. It looks like a World War I battlefield, just trenches and moats there, waiting to be broken open. Michael's not known to start very fast. Michael sort of picks up speed in second, third, and fourth round.
And we're certainly seeing that right here. Combination thrown by Alvaro Yaki Lopez.
Three very, very hard hooks to the midsection that landed, all of them, right on the target. Michael did not block any of those with his elbows.
We are live on NBC Sports World. Marv Albert, NBC's boxing consultant, Dr. Ferdy Pacheco. Sphinx throwing the jab. This is round one action from Atlantic City, New Jersey. Lopez with the right hand that was smothered by Sphinx. Good combination by Lopez.
Lopez the aggressor, as he figures to be, pressuring, driving him against the ropes. That's his fight. He wants to punish Sphinx. He said that in the interviews, and he's doing it this first round.
And we are final seconds, round one. And they're ending with a flurry.
Shelf.
Urging brother Michael on. Round two. Michael Sphinx in the black and Yaki Lopez in the green. Ring Magazine has Sphinx ranked fourth this month, Lopez sixth in the light heavyweight division. Round one to Yaki Lopez.
Definitely. Sphinx has opened this round with some very hard jabs, which has gotten Yaki's forehead red already.
Has proven to be a world-class fighter despite his relative inexperience as a pro. This is only his 15th professional fight. He blames the inactivity on a knee injury, also on his attempts to straighten out brother Leon. He said that kept his hands full. I don't know. That time Sphinx able to land on Lopez, who tried to counter.
Lopez following his game plan of driving Sphinx to the rope and battering him to the body when he gets to the ropes. Of course, Sphinx's plan is to make him pay for that as he starts coming in. So far, both men have exchanged heavy leather with no visible effect.
And we'll be hearing from Leon Sphinx right throughout the fight. That's a combination by Lopez.
Lopez's right hand getting in that combination drove Sphinx back. We're definitely going to see what makes Michael Sphinx tip in this fight, because he's up against a terrible opponent. He is strong and he is determined. Sphinx threw a dynamite right hook that missed by centimeters, but it missed. That's all that counts.
Sphinx in the black, Yaki Lopez in the green, and we have a minute remaining.
And we have a great fight. So far, it looks like Yaki is absolutely not intimidated, and he's coming on. This is truly a crossroad fight. This is character building time. The excitement is mounting here in the hall because they sense that Yaki is determined and out to get his fifth chance at the championship.
Times Lopez went 15 rounds for the title, lost a tough one to John Conte back in 76. And two highly disputed decisions at the hands of Victor Galindez, and of course the tremendous brawl against the WBC champ, Matthew Saad Muhammad.
Well, Yaki's really fighting very, very well. He certainly lost nothing in that fight. What he said was exactly right. He gave the punishment. He didn't take it. He just wore out.
Well, second round coming to a conclusion, and we'll be back in a moment. Jersey Joe Walcott at ringside. He is the commissioner of the New Jersey State Athletic Commission. As we go to round three, it's Michael Spinks in the black trunks, Yaki Lopez in the green. And what's the 30 Pacheco scorecard for the first two?
So far, I have Yaki ahead. Michael Spinks' corner, Nelson Bryson, McCall, and Georgie Benton have sent him out to take charge this round. They said, you're letting it slip away those first two rounds. Now start taking charge.
Lopez, his usual aggressive self, and thus far it has paid off. Spinks able to get in, and he hurt Lopez. Yaki able to recover.
Well, I sent Michael out to go to work, and Michael's gone to work. But it's not so easy with Yaki Lopez. He'll stand there with you. This is what Yaki wants, toe-to-toe. It's in his favor.
Left hook by Lopez. He showed us a double hook a moment ago. Tremendous combination by Lopez.
Tremendous action right above us. There's a little nick on Yaki Lopez's face as they trade evenly.
We're halfway through round three. Lopez ahead over the first two rounds.
Devastating body shots of Yaki are slowing Michael up. Just when Yaki gets started.
My brother Leon Spinks again urging his brother on.
It can't help Michael because he's getting those thudding body shots. There's another one, and that one was below the belt. He's going under. He's going over. He's mixing him up. What a veteran fighter Yaki Lopez is. He's showing everything today. He's on the offensive. He's taking the last half of this round. Feverishly by his corner for a small cut that's beginning to open up. Benito Casey, Joe Guzman, and Hank Caracal have been working feverishly over his eye. It doesn't look like much right now, but with him, you can't tell.
It is over the left eye, and as we mentioned earlier, those of you who are part of the course, Spinks was able to land, but not the full impact.
It's a great right hand.
And a left hand by Spinks. And a double left by Spinks. Spinks.
Michael standing toe to toe. That can be very, very dangerous for Yaki Lopez.
And you're watching Yaki's wife and son take it in. Michael Spinks with excellent combinations to the head of Yaki Lopez here in round four with 1 minute left on. The voice behind us is that of Leon Spinks.
Time and again.
started slowly has come on with a rush, starting at round three and now here at round four.
And he's breaking up Yaki Lopez. He's got several small cuts, but Yaki comes on. There's a whole series of punches, all of which are landing on Michael Spinks. You got to say this for young Spinks. He can really take a punch.
Than a minute remaining. Round four, it has been a slugfest right through.
And Leon hollering, take it to him, brother, take it to him. Both men temporarily exhausted. Both men have stopped to sort of look at each other and say, you want to keep this going like this? And they do, because they're going to have to go at each other full to win.
And again, combinations by both.
Beautiful combinations by Michael Spinks, who's beginning to find the range. But Yaki doesn't.
Yaki Lopez rallies here late in round four. Oh, what a slugfest! And Spinks was hurt just a moment ago. With round four coming to a conclusion. Yaki Lopez in the green, Michael Spinks in the black. We're live on NBC Sports World. It's been another big day here on NBC. The KC Royals evening up the World Series at 2 apiece by beating the Phillies 5-3. Tomorrow, both football and World Series baseball on NBC. Check your local listings. Game number 5 coming up between the Kansas City Royals and the Philadelphia Phillies. And what a battle it's been here at Convention Hall in Atlantic City. Mark Albert and the Pike Doctor, Freddie Pacheco, and we are watching along with you, Michael Spinks, 25 years old, against the veteran Alvaro Yaki Lopez out of Stockton, California.
Spinks has dominated this round so far. He started out very, very strong. He's landed some very hard punches. He's slowly breaking up Yaki's face. However, that's the way all the rounds have started, and then Yaki comes on.
That right hand did not connect.
Break!
And the referee, Vinny Rinone, with a rare break. That's the kind of action we've had.
He's hardly had to do any work. He's an excellent referee. A piece of cotton just flew out of Yaki Lopez's ear.
Left hand by Lopez.
Lopez throws punches like a seasoned pro that he is, 2 and 3 in bunches. He doesn't throw one at a time. And that's causing Spinks a lot of trouble.
You and I recall the brawl telecast on NBC Sports World. Lopez and James Scott, the Railway State Prison. And, of course, Lopez in that classic with Matthew Saad Muhammad this past summer.
Spinks has just said something to the referee. He thumbed me in the eye, he said. He's clinking because he can't see good out of one eye. And he hollered at the referee.
And Lopez able to take advantage with the left hook and then the right hand. A minute left. Round five, but left by Spinks.
Lopez has tiny cuts over his eyes, both eyes, and on the bridge of his nose. They're not big yet. They're not a question yet, but they are opening up. In the meantime, Spinks has taken the beginning round, and now here comes Yaki again. He needs to take this round. He is behind. If he's going to pull this fight out, he's going to have to start winning rounds.
Right hand by Spinks. And we have 15 seconds left in the fifth round. Seconds of the round.
Benito, Casey, and Joe Guzman working feverishly on the cuts. They've got an ice bag going on the lumps and bumps. The referee has just come over and said, take some of that Vaseline off. There's too much Vaseline on there. But in all, they're
come
doing
on, baby,
a masterful
right. You're
job
the
on the cuts. Great corner work.
Come on.
And apparently Mike Spinks is all right, as you mentioned. He claimed that he took a thumb in the eye. They're attending to the right eye of...
Round six.
This is round six.
How do you have it so far?
Well, I think Yaki's ahead. No question. It's been an even round. Spinks took the last. Now comes the time when the endurance is at stake. Can an old veteran like Yaki last? Punching machine. Have you ever seen anything like this, Alvin, where he just doesn't quit punching?
Michael Spinks blocking Yaki Lopez, and Lopez is hurt. And Spinks wants to put him away. Lopez trying to hang on.
And the referee doing a tremendous job of breaking him up. No doubt about it. Yaki's in trouble.
They're in round six, and Lopez looking to make it back, able to land with a left hook.
That's that experience. He got tied him up. He keeps getting thumb.
Spinks complained last round that he was thumped in the right arm.
He's getting thumbed, but he doesn't know what to do about it, and complaining to the referee doesn't help.
And we're midway through round six. Jarring blows thrown by Mike Spinks.
Spinks, no question, is finding the range with clean shots. But Yaki just comes back. He looks like he's cutting them out. There's blood on both cheeks. There's blood on the mouth. There's blood over both eyes and on the nose.
Head by Spinks. Left sixth round. We're scheduled for 10. Matchup of light heavyweights. Michael Spinks in the black. Yaki Lopez in the green. And after a slow start, Michael Spinks has come out strong.
And Yaki is taking some awful shots and still stands there. Right above us. A lot of give and take there.
Combination by Lopez and Spinks. Now the referee, Vinny Rinone, breaks the fighters. So we're winding down sixth round from Atlantic City, New Jersey. Several rounds back. I don't think too many folks thought there would be a round seven. But this is round seven with Michael Spinks in the black unloading on Yaki Lopez in the game. And looking to end it right here. Right hand by Spinks.
Yaki's in trouble.
Spinks looking to conclude. Significant victory of his career, taking out the veteran Yaki Lopez. As you look at the Lopez family, and well, that's tough to take in from ringside, but of course Yaki Lopez has been through the wars, a record now of 51-11, and he has been at the other end of it some 31 times by knockout. This only the fourth time that Lopez has been stopped, and here's how Michael Spinks did it. Right hand by Lopez. And another right hand by, should say by Spinks. And that is Lopez going down for the first time. And then he was put down once again. So Michael Spinks continues his unbeaten streak. This is 15th professional bout, and he has won all 15, 12 now by knockout. As Lopez congratulates Spinks, we'll get the official announcement by Frank Sheen.
Okay. Thank you, man. Thank you very much.
Over here.
Yeah.
Over here,
man.
We're not doing
anything.
All right, Bob.
Seventh round, TKO. Michael Spinks over Yaki Lopez. And we'll be back. And we'll hear from Michael Spinks right after this word.
All right, here we are with Michael Spinks, who scared everybody half to death before he won this fight, but win it he did. Michael, that was some come from behind.
Yes, it was. Well, I feel that, I had to feel Yaki. I saw him doing everything that he was doing against the rest of the opponents he fought, but with me, I figured it was a different story. You know, he had to fight me differently, fought all the rest of them. So I just took my time, and I figured he was going to be wide open for the Spinks Jinx, and I almost knocked his head off with the Spinks
Jinx.
Well,
you laid it on him. There it is. Now look on replay as we and the fans look for the front. That was the first knockdown. Now he gets up, and you come back again.
That's right. You see it in St. Louis? You see it in Philadelphia? Did you see it in Baton Rouge and New York?
All right.
All over the world.
Now what? Now what, Michael?
Everybody, all of them. The two champions. I'm going to get my promoter to try to get them all for me. Both of them. If I pick one, I feel I'm slighting the other. So either one of them is all right with me. I feel I've knocked both of them out.
Well, you have a lot of strength here. You have Leon with you hollering and screaming.
Yes, sir. And that's my main man.
That's my man.
I thank the Lord for all he's done for me this evening. Thank God. Thank God above. Everything.
All right. Thank you very much,
Thank
Michael.
You,
You've been a tremendous fighter. Back
Don't
to Marv Albert.
So the Spinks Jinx did it, says Michael Spinks over Yaki Lopez, 46 seconds of round 7. Now to Merrill Harmon in Kansas City for a World Series update.
Thank you, Marv. We're at Royal Stadium in Kansas City, side of the 1980 World Series, Kansas City edition. You know, a World Series produces many heroes, and certainly...
Two apiece, it all begins with NFL 80 at 12:30 p.m. Eastern Time. That is tomorrow, right here on NBC. So that about wraps it up from Atlantic City, New Jersey. Marv Albert, along with Dr. Ferdy Pacheco, saying thank you for tuning in. The executive producer of NBC Sports World is Don Ohlmeyer. The coordinating producer of Sports World is Linda Johnson. Coordinating director, Bob Levy. Boxing produced and directed by Ted Nathanson. Bowling produced by Matthew McCarthy. Directed by Harry Coyle. Technical director, Sal Nagita, Steve Cimino, and Bruce Berquist. Production coordinator, Carla Engelman. Associate directors, Matthew McCarthy, John Libretto, Jim Robertson, Ray Benassi. Next week on Sports World, the Charlotte 500 Grand National Auto Race from Charlotte, North Carolina, the Legends of Bowling, and the AIAW National Women's Collegiate Swimming Championships. All next Saturday on NBC Sports World, starting at 4 o'clock p.m. Eastern Time. And tomorrow here on NBC, a football, baseball doubleheader beginning at 12:30 Eastern Time with NFL 80, followed by NFL football. And then it's Game 5 of the World Series right here on NBC Sports.
A promotional fee has been paid to NBC by United Airlines. United serves more of this land than any other airline. That's what friendly skies are all about.
When you want a great hotel that puts you in the center of things, let Sheraton put you there. Call 800-325-3535.
World, and it was brought to you by the 1980 Volkswagen Dasher, Scirocco, and Rabbit. Volkswagen does it again. And by Arwax.